noticing the gentle rise and fall of the belly as you inhale and exhale. And just allowing the lungs and the rib cage to fully expand as you inhale. And as you exhale, just appreciating how the ribs move closer together as you take that nice long exhale. So today I want you to think about, last week we talked a little bit about the concept of self-discipline. So that's one of our niyamas. In Sanskrit, it's referred to as tapas. And surprisingly, as if it were foreshadowing for this week, that was actually the intention that we picked for the entire facility this week was self-discipline. So I think we can continue this theme into our practice this week as we talk about just kind of staying with things that maybe are a little bit uncomfortable for us. So if you're just joining us, we're in your variation of fish pose on our backs. So thinking about the concept of just staying with something, even though it might be difficult or challenging or uncomfortable, and kind of coming up with some strategies that we can use. So I think in our yoga practice, we tend to use our breath. We kind of notice how we can synchronize or link the movement with the breath, especially in this vinyasa style practice. Thinking about how when you move off of your mat, what might be some things that you would be able to carry with you to help reduce feelings of stress or anxiety. So maybe it's just longer breaths. Maybe it's diaphragmatic breaths. So really thinking about what you can take off of your mat with you today to maybe be able to be a little bit more calm as you go through times that are difficult. So if you're joining us right now, we're taking a modification of fish pose just for a few more breaths. So on your backs, palms down underneath the sacrum, shoulder blades walk underneath you. So you open the heart, just lifting the chin just slightly, opening across the throat and the heart center. As you continue to breathe deeply, go ahead and set an intention or a dedication for your practice today. So maybe it's figuring out what that concept of self-discipline means for you. Maybe there's someone in your life that needs a little bit of extra love or positive vibes. Whatever that is, bring it into your heart. Take one more cleansing breath, inhaling through the nose, exhaling big heavy sigh. And then if you have your hands underneath you, go ahead and just slide them out. Take a breath in. As you exhale, draw the knees into the chest and just kind of start to massage out the low back. So a nice, easy knee hug. Maybe make some circles on the mat with your low back. And then go ahead and exhale the left leg long. So pull the right knee into your chest and tip it over towards the left shoulder, extending out through the right arm. So keeping the back of your pelvis on the mat if you'd like, or moving more into a spine twist here. So you're gonna allow that right leg to come all the way over to the left and then turn your gaze to the right. Nice big breaths here. Let that right side of the lower rib cage expand. As you exhale, pull both knees back in, drawing them in nice and tight. Pull your forehead up to your kneecaps, rolling yourself into a nice tight ball. Feel that rounding in the spine. Breathe in. As you exhale, right leg extends, left knee draws in. Tip it to the right shoulder. Extend the left arm out. Look over your left hand. Twisting further if it's available to you, and if not, don't worry about it. Continuing to breathe here. As you exhale, bring the knees back to center. Take them to 90 degrees. So your arms are gonna be flat on your mat. We're gonna start to move into a bicycle just with our lower body here. So breathing in, as you exhale, extend the right leg. Inhale, come back to center and switch sides. Extend the left. Good, and then we're gonna move a little bit quicker. So right leg extends, left leg extends. Right leg extends. Left leg extends. The key to this is keeping your low back on the mat. Try to relax your head as well. So you're really focusing in on drawing the navel into the spine, lowering the leg as much as you feel comfortable without allowing that low back to pop up off the mat. So we're gonna do four more repetitions here. Really focusing in on neutralizing and engaging the lowest part of your belly. Good, come back to that 90-90 position. Bring the hands back behind your head this time, but don't interlace your hands. So spread your fingers nice and wide. And now we're gonna add that upper body. So we're gonna twist right shoulder, left knee. So you're gonna twist, extending the opposite side. Come back to center, and then switch. Left shoulder, right knee. Center, right shoulder, left knee. All the way flat in the middle there. Letting your head relax all the way down. Right shoulder, left knee. This is slow and controlled here, yogis. Focusing on that midsection. Right shoulder, left knee. Left shoulder, right knee. Good, one more time each side. Continuing to breathe as you move. Good, come back to center. Keeping your knees at, or your legs at 90-90. Go ahead and release your arms down. As you exhale, I want you to start to roll up the length of your spine. Come into your variation of boat pose in sitting. So really focusing on that midsection, chest is lifted. Remember in boat pose, there's lots of choices. So if you don't want to lift your legs up, you're just going to hinge back, still keeping your chest lifted. You want to explore more of a challenge, you're going to try straightening your knees and floating your arms up. Good, breathing. Good, we're going to stay for four more breaths. Remember, we're focusing in on that self-discipline, staying with things that might feel a little bit uncomfortable today. Two more breaths. Good, as you exhale, release and lower. Take a deep breath in, lengthen upward. So lift the chin up towards the ceiling, open the heart. On an exhale, seated bound angle pose, soles of the feet together. You're gonna walk your fingertips back behind you, tenting the fingers, come to a seated heart opener. So you're gonna draw the shoulder blades together, lift the chin, gazes up, breathe into the front body. Good, two more breaths. On an exhale, go ahead and release back to center. Take a breath in. Exhale and fold forward over your legs. And then maybe let's walk our hands over to the left side here. Breathing into the right side body. Come back through the center, forward fold, modifying your feet position as you need to. And then walking those hands over to the right side. Breathing into the left side body. Good, coming back to the center, pausing briefly here, maybe moving a little bit more forward if that's available to you. Then inhale, walk your hands back up. Go ahead, assist your knees back to center and send the legs out long. So we're gonna go ahead and straighten the right leg out. Your left leg is gonna come to half lotus pose. So your right leg is straight, your left leg is crossed over towards that hip crease. And if that doesn't work for you, it's gonna go to the inner thigh. Take a nice deep breath in here. Let that knee relax and kind of fall down to the side or fall down to the mat. On an exhale, I want you to go ahead and extend your right arm back. Take a twist. Continuing to sit tall as you breathe. Good, on an exhale, release back to center, counter twist. So this time, extending the left arm back. Keeping your spine lengthened here. On an exhale, release back to center. If you took half lotus with the left leg, go ahead and just let it relax down. I want you to start to bend your right leg up so your knee is coming up towards you. You're gonna wrap your hands around the ball of your foot. So you're gonna start to push your heel into your foot into your hand and your hands towards your feet. Take a breath in and lift your heart up. As you exhale, you're gonna press your foot out. So a little bit of an active hamstring. hamstring stretch here. Be mindful to try to keep your chest lifted the whole time. So your pelvis is tipping slightly forward versus rounding. You're pressing into the hands with your foot and breathing. Good. We're going to keep holding the foot with our left hand. If it's available to you, inhale the right arm back to twist. Good. Continue sitting tall. So lift your chest. One more breath in. As you exhale, release back to center. Counter twist. Breathe in. Right hand holds the foot. Left hand reaches back. Continuing to breathe here. Good, coming back to center with both hands, maybe pressing that foot into your hands a little bit more. See if you can get a little bit more length out of that right hamstring. Take a nice deep breath in. As you exhale, start to bend the knee and release. We'll switch sides here. So this time we're gonna extend the left leg out. The right leg is gonna come to that opposite hip crease or inner thigh for half lotus pose. Take a nice deep breath in here. Exhale and hold. Just try to relax that knee down to the floor. And on your next inhale, extend your left arm back to twist. Remember, those twists are going to come from the lowest part of our belly, so try to keep your spine nice and engaged. Use your exhale to release back to center. For our counter twist, we'll inhale the right arm back, spreading the fingers nice and wide, really opening the hand, pulling the shoulder blade towards the spine. Take one more breath in here. As you exhale, release back to center. If you took half lotus, go ahead and just let that foot relax to the inner thigh or down to the mat. Start to bend your knee. So sit tall, you're gonna bend your knee, wrapping your hands around the ball of your foot. On an inhale, go ahead and press the foot into your hand. Keep your chest lifted. So looking for some length through the back of the thigh here. It's an active seated pose. So chest lifts, pelvis tips forward. Keep your right hand on your foot. Inhale your left arm back to twist. Being mindful to keep your trunk engaged here, so not collapsing through the low back. Good, release back to center, switch sides. Inhale this time, right arm back, counter twist. Good, come back to center. Press the foot into the hand one more time. Find a little bit more length into the back of the thigh here. Chest lifts, breathe, keep your belly engaged. Nice, and exhale to release. Go ahead and make your way over to tabletop. So as we come to tabletop, hands and knees. When you're ready, drop the belly, come to cow pose. As you exhale, press away into cat. And then move the hands to the right corner, sink the hips to the left, side stretch. So we're gonna move dynamically for a little bit here to further warm the trunk. So inhale back to cow, heart forward, exhale tuck to cat, then move your hands to the left corner, sink back to the right heel. And flow with your breath here. Inhale to cow, heart forward, exhale cat. Hands to the right corner, drop to the left heel. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat. Hands to the left corner, drop to the right heel. One more time each side. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Hands to the right corner, drop back to the left heel. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Hands to the left corner, drop to the right heel. Good, breathing. Coming back to tabletop, walk the hands a little bit more forward. Find downward facing dog. Lifting the sit bones up and back. Just spending a little bit of time here and just noticing, coming into the space, coming into your first down dog of the practice. Kind of noticing how things feel here. Pedal out the feet. Start to feel that length into the back of the legs, the calves, the hamstrings. Remember, you're always welcome to take a resting pose of your choice. Everything that we do is a suggestion. So if you're getting tired or if you need a little bit of extra time in any pose, just take it. So eventually bringing your feet back in so they're hips distance apart. On an inhale, float forward to plank pose. And actually, go ahead and set your knees down on the mat for the first time. So a lot of times we talk about rounding out through the shoulder blades. We're going to practice just a couple repetitions of that, what that should look like. So if you focus on the shoulder blade area, I want you to push away from the mat as much as you can. So you're thinking about moving the shoulder blades around your rib cage and then release and kind of sag your heart forward down towards the mat. So exhale, press away. You're really rounding out the shoulder blades and then inhale, release. Good. Exhale, press away. This is what we're going to do in plank and release. One more time, press into those shoulder blades and then tuck the toes under and find plank. So if you're not used to doing that, I want you to just kind of notice what that feels like. So really allowing us to find some additional activation around the shoulders and the shoulder girdle. If plank from your toes is too challenging today, you're gonna drop down to your knees, but still keep pulling the belly in. On an exhale, press back to downward facing dog, hips high. Take a couple of nice deep breaths. Inhale to plank pose. Press into that middle part of your back and breathe. With your right leg, go ahead and float it. And I want you to take your right knee and pull it to the left elbow. Good. And then switch legs. Left leg, right elbow. Good. Switch. And think about that nice cat back. Left leg, right elbow. Good. Pause in plank and exhale to downward facing dog. Two breaths. Inhale to plank pose. Press into that middle part of your back again. This time we're going to switch elbows. We're going to alternate left to right, but we're going to go to the outside of the elbow. So starting with your left leg, pull it to the outside of your left elbow. Send it back, right leg, right elbow, send it back, left leg, left elbow, cat back, right leg, right elbow. Good. One more time, activating those obliques a little bit here. And right side, release to plank and hold. Finding that warmth in the midsection here, pull the belly in, exhale, downward facing dog. Nice job, yogis. Good. Take a couple of cleansing breaths here. And then look forward towards your hands. Walk up to the top of your mat. Find forward fold, Uttanasana. Just let the upper body sway a little bit here. Relax the back of the neck. Maybe grabbing opposite elbows or just letting your fingertips dangle towards the floor. Good. Inhale to a flat back. Halfway lift. Top of the head is forward. Shoulder blades draw together. Exhale. Round and fold. Inhale. Press through your feet. Take your time. Come all the way up to stand. Look up. Exhale. Bring the hands together at heart center. Good. Taking a pause in mountain pose. Hands to heart center. Blink your eyes closed. Just connect with yourself in standing. Take a moment to notice how your weight is distributed. See if you can equal out your weight from right to left. Notice the toes, notice the heels. Pull your belly slightly in, lift your heart. On an inhale, blink your eyes open, sweep your arms all the way up. As you exhale, open the heart, little back bend. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands, step or hop back to plank pose. Your first vinyasa from your toes or your knees, lower halfway, chaturanga, low push-up. Release to your tummy, inhale, lift your heart, baby cobra. Shoulder blades draw together. Exhale, downward facing dog. So sun salutation A, look forward, walk or step to the top of your mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, round and fold. Inhale, sweep all the way up. Look up. Exhale, open the heart, little back bend. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, plant your hands, step or hop back to plank. Vinyasa, lower halfway, low push-up. Inhale, back bend of your choice, baby cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg high, reach through that foot, maybe circle out the ankle or the knee. Big exhale, step it forward, rise up to warrior two, pivot the back heel down. Good, turn the palms up today. Think about dropping the shoulders down away from your ears. Check your knee over ankle alignment. Settle a little bit further into that front leg. Tailbone tucks under and breathe. Good. Inhale, straighten the front knee. Turn the palms down. Exhale, reach forward through the right hand triangle pose. You're going to take your hand to your lower leg ankle or block. Reach the left arm up. For a little bit more opening through the heart, take that left hand that's up towards the ceiling, reach around for the right hip crease. Kind of drawing that shoulder blade back towards your spine. Micro bend in that front knee. Continuing to breathe. Good. Inhale, float that left arm up. Exhale, shift onto the front leg for half moon. So block if you need to, otherwise fingertips to the floor. If you'd like to take a hip opener in this pose, you're going to start to bend that lifted leg, reaching back for the foot, press the front of the hip forward. If you're not quite to reaching your hand to your foot, then you can just simulate by bending your knee. Good. Continuing to breathe. Releases warrior one. Hips are square to the front, knee over ankle on that front leg. As you exhale, release the hands, interlace them, draw down and back, open the chest, lift the gaze. Continuing to breathe. Good, inhale, release the hands, sweep them up. Exhale, take your hands down to the mat, step back to plank pose, vinyasa or downward facing dog. Inhale, back bend of your choice. Exhale, down dog. Two breaths. Spread the fingers nice and wide. Ground down through the hands here. Inhale, left leg high. Three-legged dog. Reach into that foot. A little bit of movement if that feels good. Big step forward. Warrior two. Virabhadrasana two. Settle into that front leg. Good, turn the palms to the sky. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Tail tucks under and breathe. Beautiful warrior twos. Maybe a little bit more bend in that front knee. Can you stay? Pull the belly in. Good, inhale, straighten the front knee. Turn the palms down. Exhale, reach through that front hand. Triangle pose. Side two. So lots of variations for the hands. If you don't have a block, don't worry about it. You can rest that left hand on your lower leg. Whatever works out best. Keep reaching through that ceiling hand. Optional, open the heart. Take that hand, reach around for the left hip crease and breathe. Shoulder blade is open. Gaze is up or down, whatever feels best on your neck. Good, inhale, reach that right arm all the way up. As you exhale, shift forward, half moon. Just like we did on the first side, once you come into half moon, explore some hip opening here. So you're going to start to bend that right leg, reach your right hand back for the foot. If you can't grab it, don't worry about it. Press the front of your hip forward. Breathe. Lots of energy in that standing leg. Slowly release. Warrior one. Virabhadrasana one. Look forward. Good. As you exhale, press your hands towards me. Separate the shoulder blades. Slight tuck in the chin, mid-back stretch. Breathe in between the shoulder blades here. Good. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, take your hands down to the mat. Step it back to plank pose. Vinyasa or down dog. Lower halfway, low push-up. Inhale, back bend of your choice. Exhale, downward facing dog. And release to child's pose, either with your arms up next to your ears or tucked back at your sides. Take a couple of cleansing breaths, yogis. Fill the belly, deep breath in. Exhale, let it out. Everything that's not serving you today, you're letting go with your exhale. Notice how you feel. Take a moment to thank yourself for bringing yourself to your mat today. It's not always easy. The hardest part is getting there. One more nice deep breath in. Exhale, let it out. Good. When you feel ready, press back to downward facing dog. Just check your spacing, maybe float the heels and sink them down. I want you to step the right foot forward between the hands and then walk your hands around. We're going to come to a wide leg forward fold. So toes are going to be slightly turned inward. Use your block if you have it or another object. Just relax down, relaxing the back of the head. As you inhale, come to a flat back, monkey pose, halfway lift. Belly draws in, then shift the weight back towards your heels. One more breath in here. As you exhale, release and forward fold. Go ahead and walk your hands over towards your left foot and find Skandasana. So we're gonna come to up on the ball of the left foot. If this amount of knee bend is not available to you, you're just gonna stay up on a little bit less bent knee and bring your hands to your thighs. Otherwise, we're here, Skandasana, heel floats. On an inhale, you're gonna reach both your arms up over your head, soften the shoulders down. Try to connect through that outer edge of your right foot if it's available to you. And breathe. On an exhale, release the hands down. Walk back through that wide leg fold. Take it over to the second side. So on the right side, coming up to the ball of that right foot, chest is lifted. Inhale, one or both arms float up. Continuing to breathe as you draw the belly in. Good. As you exhale, release the hands down. Walk them back through the center. One more time, explore that wide leg forward fold. I want you to actually move back towards one edge of your mat. So I'm going to give you a choice here. If you'd like to explore an arm balance today, we're going to explore crow pose. So in your wide leg forward fold, I want you to separate your fingers, spread your palms nice and wide, and then toe heel your feet in. Find those chaturanga arms. Pull your belly in and cat shape your back. And even if you don't press into crow, I want you to just play with shifting your weight onto your hands. So the key is to look a little bit more forward so you can start to float your toes up. So play with that for a little bit. And then release is going to be back in that wide leg fold. Good. Then turn that front foot forward. forward. So whichever foot you have in front now, let's see, it looks like your right foot, for the only people that I can see on the camera. Good job. So with your right foot, you're gonna move both hands to the instep. Drop your back knee down, come to lizard pose. So a little hip opening. If you wanna shift your weight front to back a little bit here, you can. If you wanna walk down to your forearms, you can. So you kinda do what feels good to you to get into those hips a little bit here. I usually like to drop that back hip down in the front and kind of come into a little bit of a twist to the right, if that works for you. Whatever foot is forward, you're twisting to that side, but do what feels good. So our bodies are all different, so just appreciating some things feel differently or feel more restricted compared to others. So kind of doing what feels good for you. And then if you took that twist, start to slowly come out of it. And then toe heel that right foot back in so you're more in a low lunge position. Walk your hands and your leg back and come up to kneeling. So kneeling towards the back edge of your mat. Good, bring the hands to the sacrum. Tuck the toes under, camel or camel prep, whatever works for you. So elbows are back. Start to lift the chin up. Firming up the glutes here, perfectly fine to stay right here, or you might walk your fingertips down to your heels, or do one side at a time. Staying for a few breaths, whenever you come back to center, you're gonna remember to pull your belly in, so engage those belly muscles. Coming back to center, and then walking down to that tabletop position. This time we'll step the left foot forward, coming into that low lunge, moving both hands to the instep of the left foot. And then just like you did on the first side, maybe playing with shifting your weight front to back, maybe adding in that spine twist to the left, kind of dropping the front of that right hip down, whatever feels good. So play a little bit here, feel some length around the pelvis and the hips here. And then when you feel ready, if you're in that twist, try to slowly come out of it. Toe heel that left foot back in, and then step the left foot back. Go ahead and have a seat in the middle part of your mat. Swing the legs around so the soles of your feet are out in front of you. Take a nice deep breath in. Float the palms up on an exhale. Engage through your belly, but come all the way down nice and slow. So for our nice gentle inversion today, we're gonna find unsupported legs up the wall or traditional legs up the wall. So if you have a wall available to you, you're gonna send your legs up. So you're gonna scoot your butt really close to the wall as far as you can get it. If you do not have a wall that you can use, you're gonna send one leg up at a time towards the ceiling. Tuck the shoulder blades underneath you. Use a block if you have one. And then just blink the eyes closed. If you do have a block, remember it's going to be right at the base of your sacrum, so it shouldn't be uncomfortable as you rest there. Palms are up, eyes are closed. Let's take two more cleansing breaths here. Inhaling through the nose, exhale, sigh it out. Good, one more time, nice deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. The eyelids be heavy and closed here if that feels comfortable to you. Just take a few moments to scan your body. Noticing any place. places where you feel tension, where you don't need it. See if you can let go. Slowly releasing the legs one at a time. Take the next minute or so here to explore any additional poses that might feel good. So if you want to take another inversion, maybe a reclining pigeon might feel good. Happy baby. Spine twist. I'm just kind of doing what feels good for you before we make our way into our final relaxation. As we continue slowing down a little bit and deepening the breath, really returning that focus to the inhale and the exhale, making both sides of the breath nice and long. Is complete at any point, you can bring yourself into Shavasana. If you're not comfortable laying on your back, feel free to come into whatever pose feels comfortable to you. Maybe it's just laying on your side or another resting or restorative pose of your choice. So before you settle into Shavasana, take a full body stretch. Just really create some length in your body from the fingertips all the way down to the toes, breathing deeply. On an exhale, come into your final relaxation. Shoulder blades walk underneath you. Feet relax and fall out comfortably to the long edges of your mat. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out through the mouth. Breathe in through the nose. I am strong. Breathe out through the mouth. I am loved. Just let your body and your mind be at peace here for a few moments. Put a pause on any thoughts, positive or negative, and just be here. Allow the ground to support you. Let your body relax and find peace, even if it's just for a few moments today. Notice the gentle rise and fall of the belly. Notice how you control the breath.